Hi everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. And after the unit test third, now you might be enjoying today. On Monday you have to submit your unit test copies, I know it. So you all are supposed to come to the school to submit your test copies. So I am going to do the questions of the chapter circle. As I have told you, I am preparing this video for my students who are in St. John's School. Others can also get benefited using this video. So I am going to do the questions of the chapter based on exercise. Chapter based on circle, exercise is 13B. I did most of the questions of 13A in the previous video. Now in this video I am going to do questions of exercise 13B, chapter circle. In this exercise we will be doing, we will be finding the angles. For that, let us discuss the theorems which we will be using. In one of the videos, I have explained you the theorems. We will be using that theorem. So just as a reminder, I am just reminding you the theorems which we can use in this exercise. If we have an arc AB, another arc CD, center of the circle O. So when I write M AB, it means I am writing here the measure of minor arc AB, measure of minor arc AB, which is actually equal to the angle at the center O subtended by the arc AB. Measure of minor arc AB means the measure of the angle AOB. Keep it in mind. Similarly, when I write M CD means measure of the minor arc CD, which is actually equal to the measure of the angle subtended by arc CD at the center. So this angle is subtended by arc AB. So MAB means angle equal to angle AOB. MCD means equal to angle COD. Keep it in mind. MAB means angle AOB. MCD, measure of arc CD, means angle COD. You know that when arcs are equal, they subtend equal angle at the centers. I mean, equal arcs subtend equal angle at the centers. Second theorem, equal arcs subtend equal angle at the circumference. Third one, angle in semicircle is 90 degree. Fourth one, angle at the center is double the angle at the circumference subtended by the same arc. I mean, if we have two arcs AB and CD, when these two arcs are equal, they will subtend equal angle at the center. Means, when arc AB equal to arc CD, then measure of angle AOB is equal to measure of angle COD. Second theorem, what I said? Equal arcs subtend equal angle at the circumference. Let us have the angles subtended by arc AB at the circumference. The arc AB subtend angle P at the circumference. Let us have an angle subtended by arc CD at the circumference, angle Q. So angle Q is subtended by arc CD, angle P is subtended by arc AB. So when these two arcs are equal, they will not only subtend equal angle at the centers, but also equal angle at the circumference. So therefore, we can say that angle APB equals to angle CQD. As we said, angle AOB equal to angle COD. Third one, I said angle in a semicircle is 90 degree. Means, if you draw its a diameter, when you draw the diameter of the circle, you divide the circle into two equal parts. Each part of the circle is called the semicircle. If an angle is subtended by the longest chord, I mean the diameter at the circumference, then the theorem says that this angle will be 90 degree. And we say that angle in semicircle is 90 degree. If you rub it, you can say that you have only a semicircle. It's a semicircle. So this angle will be 90. Similarly, you can have another angle on the diameter. Diameter is subtending this angle at the circumference, this angle at the circumference. You can have many angles. So all these angles will be 90 degree because of the theorem. Angle in semicircle is 90 degree. Next theorem. If we have an arc AB and the center is O, so when I join AO and BO to get angle AOB, I mark another point P and join with AP, A with P, B with P. So this is an angle subtended by arc AB at the circumference, and this is the angle subtended by the arc AB at the center. So theorem says angle at the center is double the angle at the circumference subtended by the same arc. So this arc AB is subtending the angle O and angle P. O is at the center, P is at the circumference. So theorem says central angle is double the circumference angle. Keep it in mind. This angle is double the circumference angle if the angles are subtended by the same arc. Now I do questions of 13B. Question 1. Part 1. We have 3 points on the circle P, Q and R. The measure of minor arc PQ is 4x minus 2 degree, while measure of the minor arc PR is 6x plus 6 degree. Measure of another minor arc QR is 7x minus 18 degree. We have to calculate the measure of minor arc QR. Its value is equal to 7x minus 18 degree. So as I said, this P, the measure of minor arc PR is 6x plus 6. Measure of this arc is 7x minus 18. Measure of this arc is 4x minus 2. So when I consider here the center O and join these points with the center O, I said measure of minor arc PR means the angle POR. Similarly, measure of minor arc QR means angle QOR. Measure of minor arc, which is 4x minus 2. Measure of minor arc PQ means the angle POQ. So, you know, sum of these angles is 360 degrees. These three angles are subtended by these three different arcs. Okay. Sum of these three angles is 360 degrees. So what shall we write? Since measure of minor arc PQ plus measure of minor arc PR plus measure of minor arc QR means angle POQ plus angle POR plus angle QOR and their sum is 360 degrees. So let us put their values. Measure of PQ, 6x plus 6. Measure of PR. Measure of PR is 6x plus 6. Measure of PQ is 4x minus 2. Measure of RQR is 7x minus 18. And their sum is 360 degree, which is a linear equation in one variable. Let us simplify. 4, 6, 7. 7, 6, 13, 13, 4, 17. 17x. Minus 20 plus 6. Minus 14. is equal to 360 degree. 17x is equal to 360 plus 14. 17x is equal to 374. So x is equal to 22. X is equal to 22. So put here, we want measure of minor arc QR. Therefore, measure of minor arc QR is equal to 7x minus 18 is equal to 7 multiplied by 22 minus 18, 154 minus 18, 136. So measure of minor arc QR is 136 degree. Second part. We have to find the measure of angle BOC. Measure of angle BOC in this diagram. We have a diameter AOD. So measure of arc AD is 10y degree. Measure of arc AD is 10y degree. We have points on the other side as B and C. These points are joined with the center O. The measure of minor arc BC, it's given that 6y degree. Let us find out measure of BOC. This one we want. Since, as I said, that measure of AD is 10y. So measure of AD is equal to measure of angle AOD. And this angle AOD is 180 degrees, straight angle. So right here, since measure of arc AD is equal to angle AOD, which is straight angle 180 degrees. Therefore, 10y is equal to 180 degree, y is equal to 18 degree. Hence, measure of angle BOC is equal to measure of arc BC is equal to 6y is equal to 6 into 18, 108 degree. Next one. Third part. In third part, we have to find out measure of angle AOC. Given that arc AC equals to arc BC. Arc AC equals to arc BC. We have three points on the circle. A, B and C. The center is O. OA, OB, and OC are equal because these are the radii of the same circle with center O. Given that the measure of arc AC is 8y minus 8. 8y minus 8. Measure of arc AC is 8y minus 8. Measure of arc BC is 6y. Measure of arc AC is 8y minus 8. So if arc AC equal to arc BC, since arc AC equal to arc BC, therefore measure of arc AC equal to measure of arc BC. This implies that 8y minus 8 is equal to 6y. Solve this. 2y is equal to 8. So y is equal to 4. So if y is equal to 4, then measure of angle AOC which is 8y minus 8. So 8 into 4 minus 8, 32 minus 8, 24 degrees. Answer. Next part. In the next part, we have two circles with different centers. The centers of the circles are as A and B. Given that the circles are equal, given that circle with center A is equal to circle with center B, means their radii are equal. They are of equal radius. One more thing given. Arc CD is equal to arc EF. Arc CD equals to arc EF. Arc CD equals to arc EF. To find angle EBF, to find measure of angle EBF, this angle we have to find out. Actually, it's written here 9x. It should be written here. No matter. 9x. Here 45 minus 6x. Solution. Since arc CD equals to arc EF, therefore measure of arc CD is equal to measure of arc EF. Therefore, angle, therefore 45 minus 6x is equal to 9x. 45 is equal to 15x. X is equal to 3. The value of x is 3. Hence measure of angle EBF, which is equal to measure of arc EF, is equal to 9x, is equal to 9 into 3, 27 degrees. But here, answer is 4th one, 135. Answer is wrong. Next, 5th part. 5th part we will do in the next video.